Okay, children, we'll be starting the second video today as part two of relative velocity. We come across the problems of rain and man. Suppose the rain is coming down vertically, then of course the rain is coming downwards. I'll have to lift my umbrella upwards. And I'll point the umbrella downwards, I'll point it upwards. So remember, when it is raining, suppose I stand here and the rain is falling vertically downwards, I'll hold my umbrella upwards like this. Right? If the rain is coming down like this, this is rain. Then my umbrella, I'll be pointing upwards like this. Keep pointing upwards. I'm not pointing upwards. So that will happen when I'm still, I'm not moving, and in that case, the velocity of rain will be actual velocity which I'll be noticing. You get frame of reference is attached to me and I'm stationary, so frame of reference is not moving. But if I start moving to the left or to the right, then my velocity will superimpose with the velocity of the rain. And in that case, I will not hold my umbrella like this, because the rain apparent velocity will be different from what the actual velocity is. Okay? So in this case, just like we did in the previous case, we choose the observer and we superimpose the velocity, what we did, V1 and VBA, and then accordingly we calculate. Okay? So we'll be illustrating the concept of rain and man with certain examples. Let's see. Alright, children, we have the first question. In still air, rain is falling with the velocity of 12 meter per second vertically. Vertically, the rain is falling when the wind is not blowing. Suddenly, wind starts blowing from east to west with the velocity of 10 meter per second. Calculate the angle with vertical at which the person should hold his umbrella. Now see this problem. We know here what is given. This is how the wind is blowing. This is how the rain is coming down like this. This is velocity of rain with respect to wind. And now wind is actually blowing from east to west. You all know, children. This is north, this is south, this is east, and this is west. So I have to find out what will be, you can see that these velocities will be superimposed, and the wind will have a net velocity, and the rain will have a net velocity with respect to ground. And you know, this is actually velocity of rain with respect to ground. This is velocity of wind with respect to ground, which is given. Now, if the rain will appear to come down like this, then this is how a person has to hold his umbrella to stop the rain from making him wet. So, we'll say like this, given velocity of rain with respect to wind is how much? 24 meter per second. And velocity of wind with respect to ground is 10 meter. Now we can need to calculate velocity of rain with respect to ground. And let's assume this angle for vertical is theta. So if we hold umbrella like this, upwards, opposite to the direction that the rain is coming. Okay. Now we already know velocity of rain with respect to wind is equal to velocity of rain times velocity of wind. We know this. No problem. Both are with respect to ground. So velocity of rain is equal to ground will be velocity of rain is equal to wind plus velocity of wind is equal to ground. And this is already shown here. With these two vectors were back to back, so this will be the result here. You can construct a right hand angle also. This will be V. So very easily you can calculate this. You can see this angle is 90 degrees between two vectors. Therefore, velocity of rain is equal to root over, that is V rain is equal to ground will be root over VWG square plus VRW square. Actually the velocity of wind is equal to ground is how much? 10 square. And this is 24 square. How much is 10 square? 100. This is 576. This root over 676 meter per second. So children, velocity of rain with respect to ground is over 676 meter per second. And the angle will be tan theta. Tan theta is still perpendicular by base. VWG divided by VRW. And VRW is how much? This will be is 24. This is 10. This is 24. So let's put in the value. It will be 10 by 24. 5 by 12. So theta will be 10 minus 5 by 12. So we know that umbrella should be pointed at tan inverse 5 by 12 from vertical. So we have been very easily able to solve this question. The angle at which it will be pointed, which will afford you to the direction of the velocity of the ray. Alright children, we have second question. To a man standing on the road, rain appears to meet him at 30 degree with the body. Right? When this man is standing here, he finds this is the vertical, the rain appears to meet him at 30 degree with the vertical. Let's see this problem. This man is standing, this is the vertical. And he finds actually the rain is coming down like this. He's not moving. And the rain is coming 30 degrees the vertical. So obviously this is velocity of rain with respect to ground. Okay? Now here the vertical. When he starts running, suppose he's running to the right, let's say the positive velocity. With the velocity of 8 meter per second. So this is velocity of man respect to ground. And then the rain appears to meet him like this vertical. So this is velocity of rain respect to man. And you want this angle is how much? 6 meter. And what we need to find out? Velocity of rain with respect to ground, meaning we have to calculate and then have to calculate velocity of rain with respect to man. Alright children, let's see. If we superimpose, then you can see that this is VRM, this is velocity of man respect to ground, and this is velocity of rain with respect to ground, and this angle is given as 30 degree. If you complete this parallelogram, this is VMG, so this will also be VMG. It is diagram clear. When he is standing, Then the actual velocity of rain is with respect to ground, and that is Vrg at 30 degree per vertical. And when it starts falling, the velocity of rain with respect to man is vertical. So this is obviously the direction. So let's work on this. Now, from the given diagram, this is a very easy question, children. From the given diagram, make sure to understand it. When his stationary is not moving, then actual velocity of rain is directed at 30 degree window vertical. Keep this in mind. This actual velocity respect to ground is not going to change. Only the apparent rate will change when he is running. When he is running at 8 meter per second, then we find that the rain is appearing to come at 90 degree, coming vertically. This is how much? 8 meter per second. He is running with respect to ground. So here, from the given diagram, we have to calculate Vrm, and children, we have to calculate Vrt. And it is very easy. When you look at this triangle, OAB, this angle is how much? 90 degree. Then, first you calculate sin 30. Sin 30 will be EB by AB by OA. So AB children how much? 8. Let's say tan 30. Tan 30 is perpendicular by base. So we have AB by OA, which implies that tan 30 is 1 by root 3. AB, AB children is how much? Velocity of man respect to ground divided by velocity of rain with respect to man. Okay, let's put in the values. So 1 by root 3 is equal to velocity of man respect to ground is 8. Velocity of rain with respect to man. We cross multiply, then velocity of rain with respect to man is 8 root 3 meters per second. So we got the first answer. Velocity of rain with respect to man is 8 root 3 meters per second. Next, I have to calculate what? Vrt, I can take sin 30. Sin 30 will be taken perpendicular by hypotenuse Vmg divided by Vrg. Sin 30 is how taken? Vmg, Vmg is 8. Vrt, I have to calculate. We will cross multiply it, so the velocity of rain from the ground is going to the 16 meter per second. So very simply, by constructing this triangle, we can see that velocity of the first question is velocity of rain is equal to man. Vrm, we calculated how much? 8 root 3 meter per second, and velocity of rain is equal to ground is 16 meter per second. Now the next time we come across a similar problem, then we will change the value of theta, and the basic concept will remain same. Okay. Alright children, here we have another technical problem. To a man running on a horizontal road at 7 km per hour, rain appears to come vertically. When this man is running on a horizontal road with a speed of 7 km per hour, rain appears to come vertically. Meaning, the apparent direction of rain is man is also vertical. There is not actually something ground. And this man is running the speed of 7 km per hour. Let's work on this. Now this is the first case. Now second case is, he increases his speed to 11 km per hour and the rain appears to meet him at 30 degree with the vertical. Right? Find speed and direction of the rain. Let's understand this problem. Case 1. There are two cases. Case 1. Velocity of man with respect to ground is 7 km per hour. Suppose this is how the man is running. And now, with respect to man, here, this is how the rain is appearing to come. is velocity of ray with respect to man. So let's work it out. Velocity of ray with respect to man. The velocity of ray minus velocity of man. Now these velocities are taken with respect to ground. So be very sure these velocities are with respect to ground. Alright children, VMD here is 7 kilometer per hour. When this person running or gently with the speed of 7 kilometer per hour, rain is estimated vertically. Now from here, velocity of rain with respect to ground is velocity of rain with respect to man and velocity of man with respect to ground. So you can see these two vectors going back to back. So VR is equal to VR plus, this will be the velocity of rain with respect to ground. And we'll assume this angle to be theta. Remember, as man will increase or decrease the speed, remember this actual velocity of rain and its direction will remain unaffected. Keep this in mind. Actually, the rain is coming down at an angle of theta with the vertical. And what velocity of rain? Vrg. This is the actual. This is not it. But as this man, the reference frame will gain speed or reduce speed, then this direction will what? Change. But actually, the velocity is like this. Alright? So let's try to relate. When I look at this problem, we resolve Vrg. If I resolve Vrg, here, if this is Vmt, then this is also your much Vmt. This angle is much 90 degrees. And then, we can take sin theta. Sin theta is not here. Sin theta is Vmt divided by Vrg. So if we cross multiply, then Vrg sin theta is equal to Vmt. And how much is changing the value of Vmt? Vmt is equal to 7. Then I say Vrg sin theta is equal to 7. I say this is equation 1. Clear? Okay, now check. Case 1 you have done. Vrg sin theta is equal to 7. Very easy. Now the same. Let's see the second part. He increases his speed to 11 km per hour. Means now Vmt velocity of man with respect to ground becomes how much? 11. So let's see here. This is velocity. Velocity of man with respect to ground is 11 km per hour. Remember, if this is vertical, then this is what? The actual velocity of wave, Vrg. Don't forget this. Right? Vrg, which we have used here, same scenario. But when he is meeting his speed 11 km per hour, then rain is meeting him at what angle? 30 degrees in the vertical. This angle is how much? 30 degrees in the vertical. Okay? And now with this angle is 30 degree vertical, this will be velocity of rain with respect to man. Okay? Alright? The diagram is clear now. So what I will do is, I will construct a parallelogram to denote the velocities. I will bring some geometrical constructions. The geometrical construction is, suppose this is point A, this is point B, this is point C, this is point D. The geometrical construction is that I draw a perpendicular A, draw A perpendicular to C. Let's understand this here. You can be mathematics. The triangle, and this point will take as what? F. Triangle AFB will be similar to triangle AEA. And why such a thing? Mathematics is not subject of physics, but you can understand it. You know that vertically opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. This angle will be equal to this angle. This is 90, so this will also be how much? 90. So this will be similar to this. Therefore, this angle will be equal to this angle. 30 degree. Okay? Hence, angle DAE is equal to 30 degree. So this is just for the information. Now, I'll be resolving, and this angle, don't forget this theta. We have already checked it. This angle is theta, I told you, the original direction of ring continues to be the where the image to be continues to be same. So we have VRT, and this one angle will be 30 plus theta. So resolving VRG along E. If I resolve VRG along E, you can see this is VRM and this is E. This is VRG, this angle is 30 plus theta, and this whole angle is 90 degree. So vertical component will be what? Sin theta. So if you resolve around AE, then what you get here? AE will be equal to VRG sin 30 plus theta. I got AE by resolving along perpendicular direction. A is equal to VRT sin theta. So this is equation 2. Again, resolving VMT along E. If we children resolve VMT along E, so basically we are wanting component of VMT at vertical 30 degree, so this will be A is equal to VMT cos 30, and VMT is how much again? 11 cos 30 is 3/2. So A is equal to how much we get? 11/3/2. This is equation 3. So we got two values of VMT is equal to, okay. Now, so if I equate 2 and 3, equate 2 and 3. If we equate, then we have VRT sin theta plus 30 is equal to 11/3/2. Now, this is equation 4. So here we got two interesting equations. One is equation 1 and the other is equation 4. What I'll do is I'll be dividing equation 4 by equation 3. Right? We divide equation 4 by equation 3. Then what do we get? Let's see this. Children, so we divide equation 4 by equation 1. So divide equation 4 by equation 1. Now remember, that is a very important checklist. I have resolved VRT along E, and I have also resolved VMT along E, and I have inverted the two components. Very easy. Once you practice. Now divide what equation 4 again? VRT sine 30 plus theta divided by VRT sin theta is equal to 11/3/2 divided by 7. So you have 11/3/14. Now these two cancel. We will be expanding by the sin theta z formula. Sin A cos B प्लस कॉस ए साइन बी बाई साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू 11 रूट 3 डिवाइडेड बाई 14, राइट। नाउ यू एक्सपैंड इट, यू एक्सपैंड देन साइन 30 कॉस बाई साइन इज कॉट थीटा, देन ये रूट कॉस 30 साइन थीटा कैंसिल आउट इज 11 रूट 3 बाई 14, सो सॉल्व साइन 30 इज हाफ कॉट थीटा, cos 30 is root 3 by 2 is equal to 11 root 3 by 14. Now taking some right hand side, so we have half cos theta is equal to 11 root 3 by 14 minus root 3 by 2. Then same is 14 children, so we get 11 root 13 minus 7 root 3, 11 minus 7 is also 6 root 3 by 14 7, 3 root 3 by 7. So children, half cot theta is equal to 3 root 3 by 7. Then cot theta will be children how much? Cot theta will be 6 root 3 by 7. So we get theta is equal to cot inverse of 6 root 3 by 7. So we got angle at which the ray is coming. Alright children, once you have theta, the angle at which the ray is actually coming from the vertical. Now we will calculate VRG. If you go to equation 1, if you see equation 1, then we have from equation 1 VRG sin theta is equal to function 7. We know cot theta and you have to calculate how much is sin theta. So you have written in class 11 trigonometry. We take this angle as theta. Cot is base by perpendicular. So base is how much? 6 root 3. And perpendicular is how much? 7. So we can calculate hypotenuse 7 square plus 6 root 3 square root of 49 plus 36 theta 108 root 157. So you can see here, we'll put sin theta is equal to this is root 157. This is a simple trick which are done in trigonometry. We have 7 by root 157. If I insert this value here, then you get VRG into sin theta is 7 upon 157 is equal to 7. Then how much is VRG children? VRG is 7 plus 7 is cancelled. Root 157. So we calculated the actual velocity of rain and also the angle at which it is coming. Okay? This is a video problem. Practice over and over again. See the video many times to go through the concept. I'm sure you'll be able to do it. Alright, children. So, I will very slow explain to you the previous concept, the last problem. It's a very technical problem. Go through this again. Now, I'll take another type of problem, that is airplane wing problem. Don't think that the pilot decides and he just goes in a certain direction. When the pilot flies, it takes into account the magnitude and direction of the wind velocity so that it can reach its destination. So we have plane wing problem. Plane wing problem. Let's see. Suppose a pilot has to fly like this. Suppose he has to fly. This is, you know, north-south, east-west. Suppose the pilot has to fly north of east at 30 degrees. This is the direction along which he has to fly. If there is no wind, if the wind is still, then he can cruise along this direction fine. But imagine a situation in which There is a wind going up north at any velocity, for example, with the velocity of wind. The wind is going up north at a certain velocity, this will come. So you can see if the pilot decides to fly 30 degree only, this will not help him. Because you can see the wind will be superimposing here and the plane will be deflected from its stand upwards. So if the wind is pushing up north, then he has to come down and then he has to fly. Maybe he has to fly like this, so that the wind will push him up here and he will end up here, not at least at 30 degrees. Right? The two velocities will be superimposing. Remember, velocity of plane is equal to wind. Will be velocity of plane minus velocity of wind. So velocity of plane will be equal to velocity of plane is equal to wind plus velocity of the wind. So you have to keep this in mind, these two velocities are taken to the ground. I will not be adding ground every time, but you have to understand that these velocities are taken equal to ground. Okay? So we see a problem to understand how the flying of a plane is affected by wind. Okay? Let's see. Alright children, let's see this problem to clear the concept about the aeroplane wind concept. An aircraft flies at 400 km per hour in still air. So velocity of plane with respect to wind is given. Or here, wind or air say, a wind of 50 km per hour is blowing from south to north. Right? So this is velocity of wind with respect to ground. The plane has to travel 500 km due northeast. So, when we superimpose, I said, the velocity of plane and velocity of the wind, then the net velocity will be directed along due northeast. Okay? Calculate direction in which the pilot should fly and time taken to complete his journey. Let's see the problem. Like I told you initially, let's understand here, this is north, this is south, this is east, and this is west. The pilot has to actually fly along due north east, means at 45 degree, he has to fly. Suppose this is point A, then this is point suppose B, where is A? But the question is that wind is going to the north from south. So if he flies like this, it will push him up. So we do like this. What the pilot has to do, he has to come down and fly. He has to come towards east, down, because when he is pushing from the south, he cannot sit like this. This is how the pilot has to come down. This is the velocity of plane with respect to wind. And wind is blowing to the north. This is the velocity of wind, and then this will be the resultant velocity of the plane. So this pilot, you can see that he has to clearly steer downwards to the east at what angle? Theta. Clear? Remember children, this angle is 45 degree. So this angle will be how much? 45 degree. And velocity of the plane here given. So let's see, we'll see. Given. Velocity of plane with respect to wind is 400 km per hour. And velocity of wind with respect to ground is how much? 50 km per hour. We know velocity of plane with respect to wind, children, is velocity of plane minus velocity of wind. So velocity of plane will be equal to velocity of plane with respect to wind plus velocity of wind. Let's clearly show you the diagram. So I'll say, let the pilot steers to the east by angle theta. I'll say, let the pilot steers to the east by what angle? Theta. This is 400 and this is 50. Now what are you trying to do? To find, what you need to find is, and one more thing is given here, distance OB. To find here theta, first how much is theta? Okay. For finding theta, I'll be using a simple concept which you can use. In trigonometry, you have done solution of a triangle, and then you have said formula, if you remember. I'll recall that formula. This is triangle ABC. Side opposite to A is A, opposite to B is B, and opposite to C is C. And you have to say the formula. The side of each angle is directly proportional to the length of the side opposite to it. So we have A by sine A is equal to B by sine B. Is equal to C by sin C. So I'll be using sine formula for solving this problem. Okay? So let's work on this. You are clear for diagonal? If this is 45, so this will also be 45. Okay? Alright, children. Now, so we look at this triangle, we'll construct it separately. This triangle, I'm making it separately for reference. This point O, this is B, Z like C, O, B, C. This angle is 45 degree. This angle is theta. I take this angle as alpha. And V, B, W is 400. And VW is becoming 50. And VP also we can do it. First thing I will calculate is the value of theta. That's crucial for us. So I can use using sine formula. Very sine formula children. Then remember VW upon sin theta, VW upon sin theta will be equal to VPW upon sin 45. We have VW upon sin theta is equal to VPW upon sin 45. Now let's put the values. Velocity of VPW is 50. Sin theta is equal to VPW is 400 by sin 45 is 1 by 2. So it is 400. So sin theta is how much? Sin theta will be 50 divided by 400 root 2, 1 by 8, 1 by 8 root 2. So children, sin theta is equal to 1 by 8 root 2. And if you put the values of the trigonometric tables, this is sine of 5 degree 4 minutes. 5 degree 4 minutes. So theta is equal to 5 degrees 4 minutes. So the pilot has to come down by what distance? By what angle? 5 degree 4 minutes. We got this angle very simply by using sine formula. Right? So one part you have already done. Now the next part you will be calculating is the velocity of the plane. Alright, children. Now we will take this angle as alpha. So we will calculate this angle alpha first. Alpha plus theta plus 45 degree will be how much? 1 degree. So problem. say alpha, have to calculate. Theta is 5 degree 4 minutes plus 45 degrees equal to 180 degrees. Alpha plus 50 degree 4 minutes will be equal to 180 degrees. How much is the alpha? 180 degree minus 50 degree 4 minutes. Okay? Then how much is sin alpha? Sin alpha is sin of 180 degree minus 50 degrees 4 minutes. So we cos of 50 degrees 4 minutes. This is the value of sin alpha. And this value is nearly 1766, I think. Sin alpha. Keep this value in mind. You can look up the trigonometric table to know this value. 1667, whatsoever. You can just tell this value. Okay? Now using sin formula. Children, we will be using sin formula again. Vp upon sin alpha. Vp upon sin alpha is equal to Vp double. Vp double upon sin 45. Vp upon sin alpha. This is going to be Vp upon sin 45. Children, we already know sin alpha is 0.7667 is equal to Vp double. How much is Vp double, children? Vp double is 4 then. 1 by root 2. So Vp by 0.7667 is equal to 400 root 2. So what is the velocity of plane? Velocity of plane will be 400 root 2 into 0.7667. Vp is equal to, this will be 363.1 kilometer per hour. So children, we got what will capture velocity of the plane, and with this velocity is going to fly what distance? 500 kilometers. So therefore time is equal to, therefore t will be equal to 500 by vp. So this will be 500 divided by 363.10. So if you solve it, then it is around 1.38. So this is good enough for the day. The plane and wind problem, I hope you have understood it. Go through the whole concept. Once you have understood it, you will be able to crack any problem on plane and wind. Okay? So this is all from this video. Thank you.